Hi everyone, this is Angela Johnson Ayers here with another episode of the Older Women Teach the Younger. And again, I'll just tell you real quickly why I decided to do it. You know, I love hearing men, you know, they're ministers and teachers, and I find so many, especially on YouTube and Facebook, so many men telling us as women, you know, how to be women, how to keep a man, how to do this, and I think that's great because God can give men insight and wisdom too. But my mind always goes back to growing up in the church and how those older mothers would teach us and put us under their wing and teach us how to be wives and mothers and entrepreneurs and businesswomen and know how to make a dollar out of 15 cents and you know, if money was tight, how to cook up some food with some tomatoes and some eggs. You understand what I'm saying? And it's good. Only another woman can truly teach a woman to be a female, to be a woman. Men can have insight and wisdom. Just like I say, I can have, if I had a son, I have two daughters. But if I had a little boy, I could do my best, but I can never teach that young boy how to be a true man. It's imperative that he have males in his life. And it's very imperative that we women, especially this day and time, teach younger women about being ladies and being women and how to still be an entrepreneur and pursue your dreams and be educated, but still know how to submit and honor your husband, how to still cook and do things. And that makes us just females. It makes it wonderful to be a female. So today I wanted to talk to the younger women. I want to share with you an experience when I was younger, right out of college. So many young people think once they get a degree, whether if it's a high school diploma or college, that they're instantly going to just, bam, wake up and start making tons of money. That can happen, but very rarely it does. And the reason I thought about this is because I have a business, Angela, the Job Matchmaker, and where I help people find their career dream and help link them up with jobs. And I've had a few successes, thank God. But this one woman, she has a daughter who's 21, and the 21-year-old says, you know, look, I just want to go into the fashion industry. And I think that's fantastic. But you have to start somewhere. And it made me think about me. You know, I remember when I went to undergrad, and straight from undergrad, I went to graduate school, and I got my master's degree. So I had my master's by the time I was 23 or 24. And so right from getting my master's, I just felt like, well, look, I have a master's degree, okay? I need to be making at least, you know, X amount of thousands of dollars. I was not humble. So today's episode for you younger women is you have to start somewhere. Do not despise small beginnings, humble beginnings. Excuse me, with the internet and technology, yes, you can blow up overnight. You can do a YouTube video, you could do some things and it could just catch on like a wildfire and you could blow up overnight and be like well-known, rich and famous. But for very few and far between does that happen. And see, what happened to me is because I was disillusioned, I had an attitude, okay? So I realized, but I always was a hustler, I always would work, I was never lazy. And so I was like, well, you know, I got to make some money. So I would start temping. Back in the day, you know, I'll be 48 in a few weeks, but back in the day, you can join temp agencies. I'm sure they still have them now. And the temp agencies would help you find jobs. And the easiest jobs at the time would be clerical. So they put me, so in my mind, I'm thinking, I didn't get this master's degree to be somebody's secretary, but I knew I had to work. But I went into those jobs with that kind of funky attitude. So the temp agencies put me in great firms. They would put me like in nice law firms in D.C., in the D.C. area, or in like Roslyn, Virginia, or Arlington, Virginia. I remember a few times they put me in to temp at these great like Raytheon Systems, Northrop Grumman, which were defense contracting firms. They placed me in great jobs, you know, great environments. And had I stayed and been humble, who knows? Maybe that secretary position could have opened up to something bigger and permanent. But when you get out of school and you have a little bit of education, and for some of you, you may not even have, you may have just the, not to say just, but you may have a GED or high school diploma. You don't even have the undergraduate degree or the graduate degree. So you feel like, you know, people give you millennials a hard time, but there's some truth to it. You have to start somewhere. So in many cases, I interned I interned many, many cases. I worked for free. I worked for a senator. And but I, the whole process of me being young with my master's, I was not the best worker because I had an attitude of, I didn't have an attitude of gratitude, and I felt like this degree, this is beneath me. Being a secretary is beneath me. Here I was working for big time lobbyists, big time attorneys. And had I proven myself worthy, had I showed myself more faithful, who knows? They may have taken more interest in me and said, wait a minute, you know, you have a master's degree? Okay, well, let's see if we can parlay this secretary job into something else, into another title. Or let me see, you have a political science degree? Oh, are you ever interested in doing lobbying work? But see, I never gave it a chance because I was impatient. I didn't want to pay the price, and I just kept going from job to job, jumping and jumping. Some of the temp jobs were long-term, and some were short-term. So I say all that to say this, ladies, especially to the younger, don't despise small beginnings. Just because you may start, you sometimes have to start out doing things that you think in your mind are beneath you, but they're not. Because see, it helps build your character. It really does. It builds your character, it teaches you patience, it gives you a sense of accomplishment so that when you do get to the mountaintop, when you get to where God wants you to be, you can look back and say, wow, you know, this wasn't given to me. I worked hard for this. I paid the price for this. You know, in this day and time, we see so many people, we see the celebrities and people, and they're making all this money, and people want to just get to that. But get your high school diploma or GED. Go to the military. You know, it's honorable to join the military or go to college or get a trade. Even with that degree, you may have to sweep floors. Look, you got people who are lawyers, have law degrees and doctorate degrees, working part-time in McDonald's, working part-time at Popeyes. Why? Because they know the value of hard work. They know you have to have money coming in to survive and live. There's a difference between a job and a career. You see, your job is what's paying your bills while you pursue a career. And I tell my clients, how desperate, like when they come to me and they say, look, there are two different categories. Either you're coming to me because you desperately need a job, or you're coming to me because you want to make a career change. You already have a job, but you now want to parlay and find what your dream is, what you were made to do. But you can't come to me without nothing and then be like, yo, I need to be on TV right now. I need my own talk show and TV show. Okay, well, can you speak? Do you need to take some elocution lessons? Like, really? Come on now. Everybody's not going to be a news anchor or journalist. How about you go to school for journalism, right? So I said all this to say this, ladies. Part you younger women. Yes, we all have dreams and aspirations. Look, I'll be 48 in a few weeks, and I still have not reached to where I want to be. And it plagues me day and night many times. I'm thinking, Lord, I have all this greatness in me, but I don't see it coming to 100% fruition. But then I have to look back over my life at the little successes. And one of the things, and I don't live by regret, and I don't have many regrets, but one of the areas I do regret is that I did not maximize my moments. When I was working as administrative assistant, I did not maximize being someone's secretary. I didn't maximize answering the phones. I should have been the best phone answerer there was. I did not maximize making copies of things. I had an attitude. It would always feel like I was drudging it and dreading it instead of saying, okay, God, build in me what I need. And I should have done that. I should have had a better attitude. And that's really unfortunate. And so don't you all do that. Don't despise your small beginnings. Even when I had jobs, I always was never pleased with them, always wanting to get to the next point. And that's not good, because you're not learning what you need to learn now. So do not despise your small beginnings. Just because you see people on TV and it seems like they jump through hurdles, you don't know their story. That's one reason I love reading biographies. Pick up a biography, an autobiography of someone that they've written, and of those people, and see where they started and where they are today. No one wakes up Oprah. Oprah didn't wake up as Oprah, the billionaire. You understand what I'm saying? Look at the journey that people's lives have to take. And don't despise that, and then keep the hope that, you know what, I'm still going to get there. And even don't think people like Oprah and Barack Obama and very successful people don't still dream and have goals. But you don't despise where you start. Look, thank you for joining me. Continue to tune into my blog. And I hope that you can subscribe to my channel. And remember, ladies, we have to help and teach one another. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.